What's up, guys? Andy here. Today we are going to talk about soy. It's Meatless Monday. Soy, for me, myself personally, is one of the most misunderstood topics in the world of nutrition. I see it all the time with my clients. I see it all the time online. I see it everywhere. People love to hate on soy. So what I want to do today is go through, let's say, 5-6 big myths or misconceptions about soy-based foods like tofu, tempeh, edamame, soy milk, and help you explain why what you may have heard online or from your friend Karen simply isn't true. So where do we begin? Well, let's start with the idea that the rainforest is getting destroyed so people can grow more soy to eat more tofu. Well, the reality is that yes, a lot of land is being destroyed to utilize to grow soy, but not to make tofu and tempeh. Rather, it's to use soy to then feed to animals to be used in animal agriculture. Okay, so let's be clear about that. The next misconception you hear a lot is that all soy that you find in the store is GMO. Now, whether or not that even matters is a story for another day, but the fact of the matter is that if you go buy tofu or tempeh at your local grocery store or soy milk, it's actually overwhelmingly likely to be organic, certainly here in Ontario anyway, right? So you can't really use that argument either. Another big argument is that soy will mess with hormone levels, okay? So soy-based foods contain compounds called phytoestrogens. Now, phytoestrogens have about 1/200th of the affinity of the receptor for estrogen in the human body that actual estrogen does. So it's a very, very weak mimic of estrogen, okay? So what follows from that? Well, you know, guys who consume soy don't have lower testosterone levels. They don't get the, you know, man boobs or whatever you hear online, right? There's no human studies that demonstrate that men who consume more soy have those kind of negative outcomes. In fact, to the contrary, what we have to, the reality we have to face is that, you know, the number one most prescribed medication for men in Canada, or certainly in the top two or three, is cholesterol-lowering medication, okay? High cholesterol levels are a leading risk factor for erectile dysfunction, by the way, and high cholesterol is one of the number one reasons to get prescribed medication. Soy lowers cholesterol. So if anything, if you're a guy avoiding soy for those reasons, well, you know, you're not necessarily doing the best thing, in my opinion. Also keeping in mind that soy is a, you know, a great source of protein across different food groups, as well as fiber and so on and so forth. Okay. Another big one as it relates to hormones is in the world of PCOS. So soy for women with PCOS. Well, the studies show that women who consume more soy-based foods actually experience improvements in their free androgen levels and their insulin sensitivity, their insulin resistance. And this is for specifically for women who are living with PCOS. So there's a lot of evidence that soy-based foods actually improve relevant indicators and relevant outcomes in women living with PCOS. Something else to think about. Okay, what's the next misconception? Well, let's stick in the world of women's health. Another common misconception is that eating more soy-based foods increases one's risk of breast cancer. Now, the totality of the human evidence suggests the following, that eating more soy is at worst neutral when it comes to breast cancer risk, and depending on the population and the amount, could actually be protective against breast cancer. There's a little bit of contextual nuance there, depending on the continent the person's from. There may be individual genetic factors in terms of how soy gets processed, but that certainly plays a role as well, okay? So we've talked about breast cancer, we've talked about hormones, we've talked about environmental impacts. Those are the big areas where soy is misunderstood. So guys, at the end of the day, you know, the reality is that soy intake is generally associated with improved health outcomes. You know, soy is a fundamental part of the portfolio diet that Dr. David Jenkins came up with that helps to lower cholesterol levels. And, you know, I challenge you to find high quality human evidence that shows that individuals who consume soy have worse health outcomes in quite frankly, in any category, right? The majority of the evidence, I'm going to put the articles I've written on soy in the link in the description, via the link in the description. I want you to check out those articles for references and further reading, and you'll see what's up. Other than that, guys, hope you have a nice day. Do not be burdened by the the myths and misinformation by your friends and family when it comes to nutrition. Work with a dietitian like myself instead. And yeah, have a good one.